My vows to the Lord I will fulfill before all His people, in the courts of the house of the Lord, in your midst, O Jerusalem.
Pai, 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 P
A reading from the book of Numbers. With their patience worn out by the journey, the people complained against God and Moses. Why have you brought us up from Egypt to die in this desert, where there is no food or water? We are disgusted with this wretched food. In punishment, the Lord sent among the people Saraph serpents, which bit the people so that many of them died. Then the people came to Moses and said, "We have sinned in complaining against the Lord and you. Pray the Lord to take the serpents from us." So Moses prayed for the people, and the Lord said to Moses, "Make a seraph and mount it on a pole, and if any who have been bitten look at it, they will live." Moses accordingly made a bronze serpent and mounted it on a pole. And whenever anyone had been bitten by a serpent looked at the bronze serpent, he lived. The word of the Lord. Do not forget the works of the Lord. Hearken, my people, to my teaching. Incline your ears to the words of my mouth. I will open my mouth in a parable. I will utter mysteries from of old. While he slew them, they sought him and inquired after God again, remembering that God was their rock and the Most High God their Redeemer. But they flattered him with their mouths and lied to him with their tongues. Though their hearts were not steadfast toward him, nor were they faithful to his covenant. But he, being merciful, forgave their sin and destroyed them not. Often he turned back his anger and let none of his wrath be roused.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, Christ Jesus, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of slave, coming in human likeness, and found human in appearance. He humbled himself, becoming obedient to death, even death on the cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every name should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ.
In the name of the
thus, the mission of Jesus is that everyone is brought back
communion with our own selves, with one another as priests, with our parishioners, and with those whom we have wronged, and those who have wronged us. And all of this happen in the name of Jesus, the source and fountain of mercy and communion. Ngayon, tayo ay babalik sa ating kanyang assignments and mga program after this retreat. After having been in communion with the Lord and with one another, and we are sent to be apostles of communion. Kanina sinasabi ang yung sign that we have got to this retreat. Nagkadefinan tayo yung sign. Pero all of this are in the service of being sent as apostles of communion in the service of mission. Ngayon, edi balik tayo sa reality. Balik tayo sa ating parokya, balik tayo sa ating diocese, balik tayo sa ating tungkol ng sarili-sarili ng mga pinag-usapan. Ito naman ngayon ang tanong. Ano ang kaugnayan ng communion sa standardization, sa centralization, sa stewardship, sa operation of parangsen? Ano ang kaugnayan ng communion sa daral patron, sa diocese and pastoral plan? Ano ang kaugnayan ng communion sa general result? Dahil kung walang kaugnayan dito, sabi nga dito sa ating retreat, walang power, hindi tayo pinigilos sapagkat walang protection, walang value, walang purpose, and walang spirituality. Ano itong mga ito? Ito ang mga pinag-usapan natin that we want to happen in our diocese. All of these are expressions. They are manifestations. They are flowering of communion and mission. Fulfillment ng communion and mission. Ito ang pinag-usapan natin. At ito mga ito ay related kamag-anak, merong deep connection with sacramental brotherhood, with sharing of goods, with fraternal and pastoral charity. Diyan ang vehicle, diyan yung value, yung purpose, yung spirituality. So, matutang, communion in mission. Kung paano ang brother? Ano ba yung standardization? Ang sabi ng Second Vatican Council sa Presbyterian Ordinis No. 20, every priest receives fundamentally the same remuneration. Fundamentally the same. Bakit? Parang-parang wala naman yung ating pagpapare. At kung meron tayong pinagkakaiba sa mga trabaho, sa mga assignment, it is the fruit of mission. Tinanggap natin ito, pero it is not the reason na tayo magkakaiba ng ating tinatanggap. Sapagat tayo ay magkakapatid sa pagbaba. Di ba napakaganda at it's so beautiful na dahil nasaan tayo, di maging naparokya, di maging parokya, yung ating responsibility ay tinatawag na mataas, tayo ay formator, o tayo ay umanap, ay pare-pareho. It's a symbol. And the standardization, it's a symbol, and it's a very strong symbol of our unity in the priesthood. And it is something very beautiful that we should strive to attain. Saan man ito magagaling? Meron sinasabi ang Presbyterian Ordinis No. 21. Speaks about dioceses. Pero mas maganda rin yung
happen between dioceses, mas maganda. If it happens in the diocese, ano ito? Establishment ng kapawalan natin. Dito mag-aaling yung ating pinag-aati-atihan bilang mga pare. At hindi naman mga pare, pati yung ating mga church workers ay nakikihati dito. Pati yung ating mga programs, evangelization, catechetics, social action, lahat dito ay nakikihati. And what is behind this? The act of sharing. So that big parishes share with smaller parishes. So that the needs of our clergy, church workers, evangelization, and our forms of apostolate will be addressed. Communion is sharing time, talent, and treasure. The faithful share with one another and with the parish. The parish shares with the diocese, and the diocese shares back to the people and to the parishes, and we call that stewardship. But that is also communion. Stewardship and communion are two words of the same reality. Ano naman yung abolition of parancel? Abolition of parancel is the fulfillment of Christ's command. You receive without pay, give without pay. Could there be better description of communion than that? Could there be a better description of communion than that? Yung dalapat, anong kaugnayan ng dalapat ron sa communion? Dalapat ron is our effort to reach out to our people, especially towards those in the peripheries. And the people are taught how to pray, to read the scriptures, to reflect and practice it in their lives, especially among the members of the family and neighbors. Ano ang nasa nito dito? Ano ang pumunuhay nito? Communion. The desire to be with God. The desire to be with one another. The desire to help one another. We could not understand Dalo Patron in any form of BEC if we don't talk about communion and mission. And pastoral planning. Priests, religious, and faithful, including those in the periphery, in the spirit of communion, look at the present reality, look at the signs of the times, and then discover God's will for all of this. And we make a plan. We execute the plan in the service of mission. Ubingin, nagtutulog-tulog tayo. Pero ang nasa ilalim ng ating ito ay the desire for communion and the spirit of mission. General example is mission in action. The communion in communion with the mission. Every priest allows himself to be sent anywhere and in any office to continue the mission of bringing about communion that was started by the one who was there before him. Itinuturi lamang na. So there is the communion between the preceding priest at the camp. There is communion with the whole diocese. The spirit of mission. Kaya hindi na dito pinag-usapan yung clinging to the assignment or selection of assignment, but being one with Jesus and preaching the kingdom in obedience to the will of the Father. Kaya kung titingnan natin, all embracing ito meaning at saka yung trust dito communion na ito. Because communion is nothing else but sharing in the nature of the Trinity. Kaya lahat ng action of the Trinity is about communion. It's about mission. At tayo ay kikihati lamang dito. At lahat ng ating mga programs, lahat ng ating gusto mangyari sa ating diocese, dito, pabalik. Kaya ito yung yung spirituality ng ating ministry. At we need to be clear about it. We need to see the contact, the connection between this. Otherwise, mahihirapan tayo. At nagkataon ang disconnect. So we are grateful to God for bringing us here. And then we pray for Father Mark, Stella, and the instrument for us to understand, to appreciate, and to give that the desire to live out that communion. And in communion with you, bilang inyong obispo, isa mga pagkakataon na ako ay nagkulang sa leadership as a bishop, I would like to ask for your forgiveness. Sa mga pagkakataon na ako ay nagkulang sa pagiging ama, ako ay medyo nahihirapan sapagkat nasanay ako na maging tuwi doon sa umaga at the transition from kuya to ama ay medyo mahirapan ako. Pero laging pinamukha sa akin sapagkat si Bishop, yung ating ama ng diocese, habang ako'y pinamahilaan sa mga fiesta. But it needs to be internalized, and I need that, and I need to practice that. Sa mga pagkakataon na ako'y nagkulang sa pagkalingan sa inyo, I ask for your forgiveness. So pray for me as I pray for you. Masanay tayo yung magkaroon ng communion, and with that, we go together in mission sa pagiging magsunod sa kalooban ng Ama. Katulad ng nangyari sa second reading, He was sent, and in being sent, He became obedient unto death. For that we pray as we continue with the sacrifice of Christ. Stand up to pray the prayer. In the name of God,
Father,
sisters who have died into the unfailing joy of your
So Brazil. God. Busy with you. Busy with you.
Behold the Lamb of God, he is Jesus. Behold him who takes away